From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Well, thanks to all the sun, beaches are packed this summer, but lifeguards are very busy. That is because of strong rip currents. In Old Orchard Beach alone, 93 people have been rescued from the water after getting caught up in rip currents. That is compared with the usual 20 to 30 rescues. One woman actually died in Ocean Park last month. Scientists with Maine Geological Survey say winter storms caused unusually deep erosion on Maine beaches, creating sandbars. The gaps between those sandbars are creating dangerous rip currents where swimmers are caught off guard. Lifeguards have some important tips if you ever get caught in a rip current.
Stay relaxed, swim parallel to the shore in either direction, and periodically attempt to swim back in. And if you still are having trouble getting in after you've swam 20 or 30 yards left or right, keep swimming left or right. You know, keep going in that direction. Eventually, you're going to work your way out of the rip.
A Thursday was a quiet day in Old Orchard Beach. No rescues. But the yellow flag serves as a warning, reminding swimmers to slow down and to be careful. Rip currents are also a big problem in New Hampshire this summer. Lifeguards have already rescued about 75 people on the north end of Hampton Beach. Many of them are boogie boarders. And if you're planning on heading down to Hampton Beach, be aware that lifeguards are only on duty until Labor Day weekend. After that, you have to wait for the local fire department to arrive. Well, two people are dead after a crash on Meadow Road in Thompson early Thursday morning. State police say a car crossed the center line and slid sideways into oncoming traffic, right into the path of an oncoming pickup truck. Both people in the car, 50-year-old Randy Bishop of Bodenham and his sister, 39-year-old Donna Pottle of Boden, died in the crash. The driver of the truck suffered only minor injuries. The cause of the crash is still under investigation. A former state representative and Korean War veteran, Ted Heidrick, passed away Wednesday night after an illness. Heidrick served in the legislature from 1999 until 2004, representing Oxford, Mechanic Falls, Otisfield, and part of Hebron. The former Marine was a champion of veterans' issues and was also dedicated years to helping local and national veterans service organizations. And Governor Baldacci has ordered flags to be flown at half-staff in towns that Heidrick represented on the day of his funeral. Officers and other employees within the Portland Police Department have a new opportunity to continue their education. The department has announced a new partnership with St. Joseph's College in Standish. Officers and employees can take online classes and earn a degree at a discounted tuition rate, and all application fees will be waived. Each officer can take up to 15 credit hours each semester. Now, the housing market is starting to turn around, but you won't find many properties like this one. The federal government is auctioning off the Ram Island Ledge Lighthouse. The 72-foot light tower sits on a rocky outcropping about a mile off the coast of Cape Elizabeth. It was built back in 1905, and the lighthouse is still in use. A foghorn blares every 10 seconds. A tour for prospective bidders is scheduled for later this month. Thanks for joining us. We'll be right back.